Hello, my friends. Thanks for joining. Welcome to a sneak peek inside the heart of Nyayo National Stadium, where history and sports converge in the heart of Nairobi, Kenya. Built in 1983, and this enabled Kenya to bid for the fourth All-African Games in 1987. Now that Kenya had international standard stadium in the name of Nyayo, the bid which Kenya easily won, and then the government thought it wise to build yet another stadium so as to effectively host these events, and an 8 capacity stadium, Moi Sports Center Kasarani, was built in 1987, the same year when Kenya was hosting this continental event. From 80, Kasarani was later on reduced to 60-seater stadium upon installation of seats. Initially, the stadium had no seats and people used to sit on terraces. Same happened to Nyayo National Stadium. Initially, it was a 45-capacity stadium, which was downed to 30-seater stadium. Also, after the installation of seats, Nyayo Stadium is not Nyayo Stadium actually. Nyayo, the word Nyayo itself, is a Swahili word for footprints. Nyayo is a Swahili word for footprints, and the name Nyayo was actually popularized by the second president of this republic, Daniel Arap Moi, when he took over the leadership of this republic after the death of his predecessor, Jomo Kenyatta. He actually promised to follow into footsteps of Jomo Kenyatta, and that is how the name Nyayo came about. In Swahili, he said, "Nitafata Nyayo za mtangulizi wangu." I will follow into footprints of my predecessor. So, Moi, being the initiator of this project, Nyayo Stadium, upon its completion, he decided to name it Nyayo National Stadium. Nyayo National Stadium. President Moi was a sports person, unlike his predecessor Jomo Kenyatta. President Moi played football. President Moi came from a community which produces athletes, more athletes than any other community in Kenya. This is the Kalenjin community. So President Moi had sports at heart, and that is the reason as to why he came up with these sports facilities to promote sports in general in Kenya. Because these two mega stadiums were constructed within 10 years, you see. So that tells you how this gentleman loved sports, and his predecessor, whom we didn't see much into sports. It is only one incident in 1965, December 11th, on Saturday afternoon at Jamhuri Park Stadium, when Kenya Harambee Stars was hosting Black Stars of Ghana for international friendly. And in this match, Harambee Stars lost 13 goals to 2. That is like 11 goals to nothing. 13 goals to 2 in an international friendly attended by Jomo Kenyatta, the president himself. So the president was, Jomo Kenyatta was actually embarrassed, and he even issued an order in Swahili, and I quote, "Nimekwisha toa amri. Nendeni mkaite Kipchoge Keino akuje akimbie na mpira." I have issued an order bring here Kipchoge Keino so that he can run with the ball. That is the order that he issued during this match. He was so embarrassed after the home team was hammered 13 goals to 2 by Black Stars of Ghana. In his mind, he thought that maybe now that Kipchoge Keino was the best athletic in the country, could as well apply the same in football. And he actually wanted Kipchoge to be brought so that he can run and score the goals, maybe equalize and even score the winner. Since this day, Jomo Kenyatta never attended any match. He never attended any sports event, be it football, rugby, boxing. He never attended any sports event. Unlike President Moi, who even sponsored a tournament in the name of Moi Golden. So Moi was a sports person, and that is the reason as to why he came up with these two mega sports stadium that we are proud of till now. I remember the Catalan was built in 90, was the last one to be built, and it was built in 1987, 4 years after the completion of Nyayo National Stadium. From 1987 to date is like 27 or so years, and we are unable to come up with another stadium of the level of the two. Nyayo National Stadium is actually located in Nairobi West at the junction of Mombasa and Langata Road, just 2 kilometers from the CBD. 2 kilometers from the CBD. Everything that was used to build Nyayo Stadium was obtained locally. Architect was Nyanja Architects and Associates, funded by taxpayers' money. Material obtained locally. So Nyayo National Stadium is 100% Kenyan. Made in Kenya by Kenyans for Kenyans and the rest of the world. Unlike today, such facilities are normally given to Chinese companies, and these Chinese companies normally comes in with almost everything of their own, including the food they eat comes from China. Wine they drink comes from China. Water they drink comes from China. So they come in with everything that is needed in that construction. So let's now look at the facilities in here. In here we can see the main stand, that one, the other side with the blue fascia board. That is the main stand where dignitaries, VIPs, VVIPs normally seats. Okay. The second facility here is football pitch. Football pitch is actually made of natural, the surface is natural grass. We also have athletics track. Athletics tracks is that tracks that you see surrounding a football pitch. We also have Indo Gymnasium houses volleyball volleyball court, boxing, basketball court, and all other indoor events. Nyayo National Stadium also has got a swimming pool. That one that you see over there, that is a swimming pool. It is actually 50 meter swimming pool. Nyayo Stadium not only hosts sports, but also events and other cultural festivals. So Nyayo Stadium is a multi-event facility. This happened recently. It was in the year 2009. The name of this stadium was shortly changed. The name of this stadium was shortly changed to Coca-Cola National Stadium after the multinational company won the naming rights. But later on, actually withdrew after the pull and push with the government on how the name should appear. For the company, they wanted the name Coca-Cola National Stadium, and that is it. But the government insisted on Coca-Cola Nyayo Stadium. Coca-Cola didn't want the appearance of the name Nyayo there, but the government insisted it should be there. The government felt that getting rid of that name would amount to erasing a section or part of our culture. So the government insisted, and the company stood firm, and eventually the deal collapsed and Coca-Cola walked out. So all that Coca-Cola wanted to do on this stadium, giving it facelift, completing the canopy, they wanted to construct a canopy over it, the way the main stand is. Coca-Cola had a plan to construct a canopy over it, but this didn't go well. After the collapse of the deal, didn't go well with the citizens. The citizens felt that the government was too harsh to the company. The citizen felt that the government would have just allowed the company to do whatever they wanted to do, because the deal was only for 3 years, and the company had to hand over the stadium back to the government. So it was just only 3 years deal. Nyayo Stadium is owned by the government and managed by Sports Stadium Management Board, a state corporation established via Kenya Legal Notice Number 180 of 15th of November, the year 2002. It draws its mandate from Sports Stadium Management Board Order 2002. This is Nyayo National Stadium from the southern part of it. And ladies and gentlemen, you will agree with me. Going by the African standards, Nyayo National Stadium looks beautiful inside. As you can see, the green football pitch, the playing surface, the football pitch is green. Actually, we have green grass there without green snakes. Green grass with no green snakes. Look at those athletic tracks in red. I believe the color is red. It looks beautiful. Just look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Guys, enjoy the view. Thank you. So let's now listen to some words of wisdom from one of our local leaders here, and then we come back and we end this video. Thank you so much guys for staying on.
Kuanzia mwaka huu tarehe 26 kutakuwa na cultural day ambayo jamii zote zitakuja pamoja kusherekea mila na tamaduni zetu kama Waafrika. Hapana kupotea. Tu wengine wanafikiri tamaduni zao ni kuzikana na kuoana tu na mambo mengine. Kuna mambo mengine mazuri ambayo kwa nje ya kutahiri tunakuoana, si ndio? Watu wajifunze kimila, waelewe ni kimila namna gani. Na watu pia kuamilia lugha zao, watu wajifunze lugha zao. Uwezi jifunza kimila zako, tamaduni zako kama ujui mother tongue. Hii vitu tunakuwa transmitted through a language. Na ndipoza wazungu kule kwao. Ukienda Russia ongea lugha nyingine, wanaongea Kirusi. Ukienda China, kitu ya kwanza ni kujifunza Kichina. Ama namna gani? Lakini hapa tumekufa na kizungu tu, hata wazee wanang'ana na kizungu tu. Unaweza vunja lugha yako kuongea vibaya, lakini Kenya hiyo ukivunja kizungu, you will become ostracized. Atajui kuongea kizungu. Yaani kama ni kitu ya muhimu, na hiyo ndiye membrane wazi tumekuwa watu wajinga kabisa. Because now we love everything foreign. Kwa sababu namaliza language zenu. Muzazi anaona ni jambo la busara sana kuambia wageni, okay, my daughter, my little daughter cannot speak Kiteso. Hata ni jambo la umuhimu natangazia ulimwengu mzima. Hata mimi naonanga wenzangu kiambo anasema anajua I'm not very good in Kiswahili. Aza dieni zata amesoma kabisa ni mstaarabu anaongea kizungu. You don't know how stupid you look. Learn your language, elewa lugha yako ya mama, fuatisha na Kiswahili, ndio? Hata kama ujui kizungu, you'll survive.
Learn your mother tongue, understand your mother tongue, followed by Swahili. Even if you don't learn English, you'll still survive. That is the message from the governor to Kenyans on importance of learning their mother tongues. The governor went on and mentioned China and Russia. I think what he meant here is that they don't speak English, but they still survive. To some extent, I tend to agree with him because Professor Ngugi wa Thiong'o once also said that if you can speak your mother tongue and any other foreign language, then that is empowerment. But if you can't utter a word in your mother tongue and you are very fluent in foreign languages, that is total enslavement. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is all I wanted to share with you in this video. Now, thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching up to this point. Now, please give this video a big like. A big one, please. A big one, please. To my super chatters, stickers, and channel members, thank you so much for your kind support, and may the good Lord bless you even more. That is it, ladies and gentlemen. Let's meet in the next video. Let me say kwaheri.